In this short video, we'll focus on a special part of our SAP best practices content for SAP Integrated Business Planning for Supply Chain, the content that enables you as a planner to get insights into the carbon emissions of your supply plan. In 2308, we introduced the Network Aggregation Operator, which you can use to calculate costs or carbon emissions. The carbon emissions are calculated for each product unit at a given location and within a given period by rolling up the carbon emissions at various locations in your supply chain. You can then compare different supply plans based on your sustainability KPIs. You'll see how changes to your supply chain affect the carbon footprint of your products. How does it work? The operator first transfers the carbon emission values of your products from the upstream to the downstream nodes of your supply network, based on the product quantities that are moving through your network. Then it calculates which share of the carbon emissions of a finished product at a given location comes from processes like production, transportation, and so on. Of course, the operator needs input data to perform the calculations, such as the emission rates for raw materials, production, transportation, and the like. You need to integrate this data from other SAP products or from external sources into SAP IBP. Let's see what it looks like in the system. An important part of our best practices content is a pre-configured planner workspace that comes with several planning views and charts. As we've said, the carbon emissions are calculated based on an existing supply plan. Let's look at the chart titled Distribution of CO2e by Product. It shows you that one specific product is the biggest contributor to the overall CO2 emissions of the supply plan in question. Let's now check the distribution by location. You'll notice that plant 1710 shows a huge amount of emissions caused by transportation. Now let's check the data on the aggregated unit carbon emissions tab for the major contributor that we've identified. The figures that we see on this tab confirm that the transportation emissions for the product and the plant in question are very high. To find a solution for these high emissions, you as the planner can create a scenario. The CO2e adjustment workbook provides you with additional details. You see, for example, that the product can be delivered by two suppliers that have the same external receipts emission rates. Checking the transport-related information, you find that even though one supplier is farther away from the plant than the other supplier, their emission rate is considerably lower. Let's find out what happens when we switch to this supplier. To do this, you use the scenario that you created. You set the adjusted transportation receipt to zero for the original supplier and maintain the required quantities for the alternative supplier. Then you run the S&OP heuristic for your scenario. The result shows you that the new scenario produces lower CO2 emissions. Mission accomplished. What's covered by the SAP best practices content? The modelling of the required key figures and planning levels is now part of the sample planning area SAP IBP1. We've already shown you the pre-configured planner workspace with the planning views and charts. Thanks for watching.